Hi, this is a video on using the LinRegTTest feature of the TI84 calculator to come up with the least squares regression line, the correlation coefficient, the line of regression graph, and the stat plot. So first off, we need to put our data in. So we have an example here of a sample of 10 professional athletes and their number of endorsements and the money they've made in millions of dollars. So the first thing is we need to put the data in. So we're going to press the stat button here and we're going to edit lists. So this first list, notice, has some data in it, so we need to get rid of that. So I'm just going to arrow up to the top of the list, the name L1, press clear and press enter, and all the data will be cleared. And from here I'm just going to go ahead and type in my data. 0, 3, 2, 1, 5, 5, 4, 3, 0, and 4. And then in the Y column, I'm going to put my response variable, the money made in millions. So L1 was my explanatory or my input variable, and the amount of money made in millions is my response variable or my output. So 2, 8. 7, 3, 13, 12, 9, 9, 3, and 10. I just want to double check that I've input my data correctly and I have the right number of data values, and I should have the same number in each column. And once I've reviewed that, we can go ahead and use stat and go over to tests. And I know you want to calculate, but we're going to go to tests. This is going to help us later in the course when we're asked where we're going to go. So I'm going to scroll up to LinRegTTest. So on my calculator, it's F, yours may, it may be E, it may be another letter, but you want LinRegTTest, and then press enter. All right, so now XList is going to be our endorsements. We put that in L1. If that doesn't show, notice L1 down here on your calculator, right above the 1 key, I would press second and 1, and it would put in L1. Same thing for Y list, that's in L2. The next line, frequency, we're always going to leave at 1. This next line, we'll talk about what you want to pick later on when we actually do the test. Right now, you can leave it to be whatever you would like. The next step is really convenient, which is the regression equation. Where do we want to store this regression equation? And to make our lives a little easier, I'd like to put this in Y1 into the graphing portion of my calculator. So we can do that by pressing the vars button, V-A-R-S, which stands for variables. And I want, it's a y variable, right? I want it in the y equals, and it is a function. So I'm just going to press enter, and y1. I'm going to put it right there at the top, y1. Great. Now I'm ready to calculate. So I just arrow down and hit enter. Notice the format is y equals a plus bx, so it's a little different from the format we're used to, which is y equals mx plus b. So note a is your y-intercept and b is your slope. And the important information we want is here is a and b. So here's your y-intercept, 2.233644486. And your slope is 1.98753894 1. And then this arrow here on the side tells me there's more information. So if I scroll down a little bit further, you notice r squared, which is oftentimes called the coefficient of determination, and then you have r, which is our correlation coefficient, which is 0.978642, etc. So that correlation coefficient tells us whether it's a positive or negative correlation and how strong it is, right? The closer to 1, it's a stronger positive relationship. Closer to negative 1, it's a strong negative relationship. If it's close to 0, it is a weak relationship. All right, so that's information we need for the least squares regression line. You have your y-intercept, you have your slope, you have your correlation coefficient. Now, if I go over and press y equals, we'll notice that our regression equation is right there. And you can, if you need to, cut out some digits, you can round this if you would like, but I'm just gonna go ahead and leave it for now. And then we want this plotted on top of our pairs of data, right? 0, 2, 3, 8, 2, 7. So the easiest way to do that is I'm going to go to the StatPlot, there it is, in blue right above the Y equals. So I'll press second and Y equals to go to the StatPlot menu. And so this first one is turned off. In fact, they're all turned off, so I'm going to turn this one on. So number one is chosen, so I'm going to press enter. All right, and then I want to turn it on, so I want to make sure that that is highlighted, not off. Great. The next is the type. This very first one is a scatter plot, which is exactly what we want, so I can arrow down, but if it wasn't, then you would arrow to that one and press enter. Our X list, notice it says is stored in one L1, Y list in L2, that's perfect if we needed to change them, right? Above one is L1, you press second, oops, that's not what I want, go down here, L1, press second and L1, great. And if I needed L2, I press second and two. The mark doesn't really matter, just a matter of preference. Do you want a box, a plus, a dot? I like the box. Color doesn't matter. And we're ready to go. Now, you might say, well, how do I do this, right? There's no calculate, there's no graph, there's no nothing. So what we're actually gonna do is use a feature of the zoom features on your graphing calculator and do zoom. And notice down here at the bottom, it says zoom stat. So yours might not have all of those, but you'll need to scroll down until you get to zoom stat, or you can just press 9. And what your calculator does is it looks at the data in L1 and L2, and it determines what the x-axis should be and the y-axis should be, and the, how far they should graph those. And it'll plot all of your data points. So let's press 9 and see what happens. There we go. There's our scatter plot, and there's your least squares regression line plotted right in the middle of it.